Hey guys, Triumph of Man here, ready to help you avoid the Dota 2 blues with another hero guide brought to you by Mobicast and DotaFire.com. This time we're examining Darkseer, a melee intelligence hero. Now, Darkseer is a utility support hero. He's a support, yes, but he's not good at hardcore babysitting. He can help out with the wards in Courier, but again, he's not a good primary ward bitch. So, how does Darkseer fit in? Well, he's a great utility support that truly shines if you give him a small amount of early farm. Darkseer is a pretty straightforward hero on paper, but he's a hero that needs good teamwork to get the most out of him. But first things first, let's look at his skills. First up is Vacuum. This does minor damage, but sucks enemies up into a cluster. With the right teamwork, this is easily one of Darkseer's most powerful effects. Suck people in, and then let your team's AoE just win. Darkseer's next skill is Iron Shell. You can cast this buff on allies or on enemies, and it deals constant damage in a small AoE for 15 seconds. You should note though, it won't affect the enemy unit that you actually cast it on. It'll only hit the enemies around that unit. His third skill, Surge, gives a target max move speed and makes them immune to slows. Surge is incredibly useful for helping an ally either chase a target or get out of trouble. Darkseer's ultimate, Wall of Replica, creates a shimmering wall that damages enemy heroes when they pass through it. In addition to this, it also creates an illusion of the enemy hero. Wall of Replica can also be upgraded with Arcanum Scepter, so allies also create illusions when they pass through it. This can cause complete chaos during teamfights. So, skill builds. We get 1 point in each of our primary skills, and then we max out Vacuum. Vacuum's area of effect increases greatly with levels, which is critical. Whether you max out Surge or Iron Shell next really depends on your team composition and your own playstyle. Personally, I get Surge to level 2, so it's guaranteed to outrun slows, then I max Iron Shell for extra DPS. Your ultimate is good once teamfights start occurring, but before that, leveling your other skills is more useful. So we save it for levels 10 and 11. As for starting items, I like starting off with a Ring of Protection, one set of tangos, one mana potion, and one health potion. If my team requires it, I also get the courier. If not, I save my remaining gold to get an early Ring of Basilius. The armor and mana regeneration aura are really good during the laning phase. Just remember to set it to heroes only. I favor getting an early Vanguards on Darkseer. This is because I use him in a very aggressive, in-your-face style, and because combined with Iron Shell, it also allows Darkseer to jungle very effectively. After that, I like to get Arcane Boots and 4 Staff. Wall of Replica is very mana costly, and Arcane Boots helps take the edge off that. 4 Staff, on the other hand, is just a great all-round utility item, plus it's really fun to bait enemies with. That said, Darkseer is really flexible with his item builds, so don't be afraid to experiment with different utility items. For example, you could get an Urn of Shadows instead of a Basilius, and then you could replace the Vanguard with a Mechasm. Remember, you can farm big creep waves really easily by casting Ion Shell on yourself and then using Vacuum to suck the creep in close to you. Now, Darkseer is capable of soloing a lane, but as you're getting used to the hero, I suggest following an ally to a side lane. This way you can get the hang of comboing your spells with him. Because remember, the key to a successful and fun-filled Darkseer is communication and teamwork. If your opponents lack strong stuns, you can be very, very aggressive thanks to Surge. In this clip, I tell my allied Viper to run down Omni Knight with Surge while I tank the tower hits for him. Viper complies, and it's an easy kill. In this clip, I tell Earthshaker that I'm about to vacuum the enemy team up. He's ready for it, and then he blinks in to unleash a crippling Echo Slam. Communication is paramount. Using a microphone to let your team know what you're doing with your spells makes playing Darkseer 110% easier and more fun. On the other hand, good communication means nothing if your teammates are going with full derp mode. Unfortunately, playing a hero like Darkseer is incredibly frustrating in these circumstances. Basically, when you get into a teamfight, drop down your Wall of Replica, try and vacuum the enemy team through the wall so they spawn some illusions, and then hope your teammates follow up with some good AoE spam. As long as this happens, you're pretty much golden. Don't forget you can use Surge to help a hero who needs good position to get where he needs to be. Also, as long as you've got enough mana left for one more Surge or Vacuum, make sure you skulk around the edge of a teamfight, because one good Vacuum or Surge could swing things in your favour. Anyway, that's the basics to Darkseer. Like I said, he's super versatile, so for an alternative or more in-depth guide, be sure to visit DotaFire.com. Or you could swing by the DotaCast stream on Twitch TV. Jump into the chat and ask me anything. Until then, clean him up with Darkseer. Triumph out.